Hey guys, so I realize this video is way long overdue. It's been over a year since I last blogged about my student debt situation. In fact, it's been over a year since I last blogged at all, period. So I'm gonna be a little rusty with this whole talking in front of the camera thing. But here I am, over a year later, ready to update you on my student debt situation and what might how the future of that might be for me. But before I get to that, I guess I just want to say it's been amazing to me, really surprising that video that I made on my student debt situation back then is still getting views, consistent views, and it's still being commented on. That's just surprising to me. It shouldn't be surprising because I know the number is huge. $105,000 in loans is a huge loan, and also I know there are a lot of people going through similar situations. Some people having worse loans, like $200,000 or $150,000 in student debt. So I shouldn't be surprised, but it's my video getting that many views, that many comments, so it's still surprising to me. I guess in a way, also I have to also thank the Young Turks Network for that many views because it was linked to there. So that's might be how it got so much attention. I don't know how the logistics of YouTube viewership works, so but anyway, I'm just surprised, and now here I am. So back then, I owed CitiBank $105,000. Now here's the crazy thing: that $105,000 is a huge amount, but it actually could have been much bigger. See, that $105,000 only accounts for 3 years of my college education. The first year, my parents paid for it. We had to move to a new house. So they sold their old house, made some profit, and some of that earnings went to my first year in college. So my first year has been paid for. Also, another important thing is I got scholarships. Okay, every year of my college education, I had at least $7,500. I received at least $7,500 in scholarships. Another big thing is, after my first year, I decided not to live in a college dorm. Instead, I found an apartment in the Bronx, and I paid for it by finding a job as a security guard. So I worked as a security guard for a year, and I actually paid my rent and all that. So even with all those deductions, my student loan still ended up to be $105,000, meaning it could have been much larger than $105,000. If I took all that out, if I didn't receive any scholarships, if I lived in college dorm with a meal plan, if my first year wasn't paid for, that's probably the biggest amount there, I would probably owe Citibank $200,000. So $105,000 is a lot, but it could have been much larger, and that's the crazy thing. Now, I know there were a lot of comments on the video like, man, you are stupid. You went to NYU for a social work degree. That's a dumb move. Valid point. I'm not going to argue with the validity of that point there. But that's why I chose to go to NYU, why I chose social work. That's actually, I feel like that's a topic for a different video for a different time. This video, I guess I'm just going to focus on my debt situation. So, as you can see in the title of the video, I now owe $93,000. Also, I don't owe just Citibank anymore. Now there's this Discover Bank involved, which is really, it's complicated. It's weird to me because it all happened without my say in the matter. It kind of makes sense. I guess Citibank just wanted to get rid of my loans as you know, somehow, any way possible, because I wasn't making the monthly payments. I was unemployed after college, a month after college, and you know, they kept calling me saying, hey, you have this much overdue, can you pay? And I'm just like, no, I can't pay, I don't have money, I'm unemployed, I'm trying to find a job right now, what do you expect me to do? And you know, the with private loans like this, they give you a certain amount of days before you default. With Citibank, it's 120 days. So I was at that point like, I was 100 days overdue, or 110 days overdue. 10 more days, and I'd be defaulted. It'd be like the equivalent of like bankruptcy. I don't really know what default actually really means. It hasn't happened yet, thank goodness. So obviously Citibank wants to get rid of this loan. And how do they do it? Well, they sell two of my loans to Discover Bank. I don't know why Discover would even agree to buy loans of someone who just hasn't been able to make the monthly payments. I guess Discover took that risk. Pretty dumb risk, if you ask me, but they took the risk. And so they sent me a letter saying, hey, we bought some of your loans. It's not going to be finalized till a year later, so you don't have to worry about paying us till a year later. So a year passed by. I actually got a phone call from them a week ago, and so they're like, you know, you have this amount overdue for Discover. Are you able to pay it? For about a year, I've been able to pay back Citibank because I did find a job. I found a job in a homeless shelter, and I worked a lot of hours. On average, I worked 70 hours a week. That was my average work week. So with that much overtime, I actually did make enough money for my living situation and to pay back my student loan monthly payments. And my monthly payment for student loan is really, really high. And that's because, and this is my biggest issue with private loan situation. The private banks are very inflexible with their loans. They say, you know, you have to pay this amount back in 10 years, and that's final. You can't change that. There are no refinancing options. There's hardly any forbearance options, nothing like that. They say you have to pay back in 10 years. That's it. In my opinion, it would be smarter for to make it a 15-year plan, higher the interest rate, and so that I can pay about $500 a month. And I could make $500 if I, you know, that's an easy thing if I had a job. And that would have been easy if, working as a worker in a homeless shelter. But they don't give you that option. So I had to struggle to make, to pay $860 every month to a bank. So that's been the hardest thing, but I've been able to do it. As you can see, I've cut down from, in the course of a year, about a year, my debt went from $105,000 to $93,000. In about a year, I paid back $12,000. Now, $93,000 is still a huge amount, but the fact that I've been able to pay back that much amount in a year is still a big accomplishment to me. Now, currently, I'm actually not quite sure if I'm able to still pull that off, because I no longer work at the homeless shelter. I lost that job. And I've been unemployed for about 3 months now. I recently just found a job, so I don't really know how it's going to go. But Discover has been really great with me. They seem way more flexible than Citibank. Citibank called me the other day, and I'm just like, no, sorry, I know I have overdue payments, but I can't make it. I just, you know, I lost my job 2 months ago. I can't do it. Discover, I talked with them, gave them the same spill, and they're like, oh, okay, well, in that case, you can apply for times of economic hardship right now. You have 12 months that you could use for forbearance. So if you choose to use about 4 months, you don't have to make any payments until January. So that's where I'm at with Discover right now. I don't have to pay them back until January. That's awesome. That kind of flexibility is all I'm looking for with banks. I know this education, going to NYU for social work, that was, you know, maybe it was a stupid choice. I don't know, but that was my choice. So I know I have to pay back somehow. I do want to pay back. You know, if I don't pay back, I know it's like debt. You know, I took this money, I borrowed the money, I have to pay them back. It's in my conscience to pay them back, and I will if I'm able to. But when I'm not able to, I only ask that you just give me some time. That's really all I need. And, you know, in my record, when I had a job at the homeless shelter, I worked my ass off to be able to pay back $868 every month on top of my rent payment, my food expenses, you know, all that. So if I can do it, I will do it. But it's just, you know, so right now, I just recently found a job as a canvasser, working on behalf of the. I don't know if I can actually reveal what I'm doing. I don't know if that's against company policy, but I'm working as a canvasser. I'm raising funds for a nonprofit organization is what I'm doing. It's a fun job. It doesn't pay very well, but it can pay awesomely. It's a merit-based work. So what that means is, if I raise a lot of money, I get bonus. And if I do horribly, I can actually lose my job. So I have to meet a fundraising quota every week. So it's a I don't really have job security at this point, but I do have a job, so that's something. And if I keep being able to do good job at fundraising, I actually can, make a living here. About the loan payments though, I'm not even sure if I'll make enough money to meet the monthly loan payments. The only reason I was able to meet the loan payments, over the course of the past year to now was because I did so much overtime at the homeless shelter. I say on average I did 70 hours a week, but some weeks I did 100 hours, some weeks I did 110 hours a week. So it's only because I've worked so many hours that I've been able to meet those loan payments. And with this job, it doesn't give me opportunities for overtime. I just have to rely on my fundraising skills to get bonuses, and that's what I have to rely on. But that's my current situation so far. And right now, my Citibank loan, they're not allowing me forbearance or whatever thing that Discover is letting me do. So, and I think I'm overdue like 60 days or so. I think I'm about 60 days overdue. So I have 60 days to pay back Citibank before I default. So, and that kind of scares me. Default wouldn't affect me that badly because I'm young. I'm still only 25. I don't plan on buying a car or putting down mortgage on the house anytime soon. It wouldn't really affect me too horribly if my credit score just goes down the drain. But it's in my conscience, I have to pay back that money because I borrowed it. It's an obligation of mine. And if that obligation is taken from me, I just feel really bad about it. So that's where I'm at right now, and this is my video. It's been a year since I talked in front of camera, so I know it's kind of really rusty and just all over the place, but hopefully, yeah, that was it. Later, guys.